So here we go. Robbie Gardoche will start off with the serve. Love all. This is the type of firepower I'm talking about. Sets up the third ball, no hesitation. He can't afford to back off or get in the rally. The longer the rally goes, the more it will favor the stronger player, which is, no questions, Ma Long. Good touch over the table, Will.
Surely, if you're Austria, if you're Robert Gardoche, you'd just be thinking, I'm going to enjoy myself here. I'm getting a chance to play Ma Long. I'm just going to rip backhands, rip forehands, as you say, go for my shots. Wouldn't you be thinking like that? You know, I know it's an almost impossible task, but you can go for it, can't you?
That's all you really can do, and so far Gardoche is doing just that. His interview last night was quite telling. He said their team is a China magnet. They've always drawn China, whether it's the group stages or later in the tournament at the World Champs. But he said he likes it because it's a real test. I mean, if you play anyone other than China, you think, well, but how would we do against the best? Yeah. So strong start back to the serves for Gardoche. Now, in terms of Ma Long, we've seen him lose the first few points in several matches, but I almost feel like it's his way of sort of walking the facility, sort of seeing what's around the corners, testing out the opponent. So good at identifying weaknesses. And that's the pressure of Ma Long. Gardoche plays two high-risk shots. He's got the serve right down the line, the follow-up attack right down the line.
I mean, great serve, wasn't
it? Everything he does right in this, and still Ma Long's right there waiting with a forehand that can't be answered. So three straight points to start for Gardoche and three right back for the dictator. He's fighting, Will.
Good exchange there, and Gardoche is going for his shots and doesn't seem to be too overawed here. He's just going for it, and that's what he's got to play like the whole game, really. He's got to leave it all out there. Come on.
Across the body here, a little bit less rotation, but yeah, the pressure. This is the type of shot he's going to have to take to stay near the table.
I love Ma Long's little look sometimes. You know when he loses a point, and you know it's a great point from Gardoche. It's sort of like a side look, as if to say, "Yeah, nice, I like that." You know he's in it.
6-3.
Yeah. Ma Long turns there, sort of rubs the bridge of the nose in thought and says, okay, time to come back. We've seen some big leads. I mean, Timo, who was world number one at the time, had what, like 9-4 and 10-5 and lost both games?
3-7.
Something similar. And even at the World Champs last year in Dusseldorf, Timo was up, I think, 8-4 in game number 6. And up or down 2-3, and Ma Long came back. It was looking like it was gonna go 7, but nope. Dictator dictates.
It's the right play there, wasn't it, from Gardoche? Trying to take the ball on, trying to play that ball.
Yeah, just a little bit low, a little bit late. I think he wasn't happy about the decision there. Again, it's a fine balance. He wasn't far behind the table, but against Ma Long, everything has to be quite extreme and specific. This receive leaves the third ball for Ma Long. The comeback has started. Second towel break. 2 points from down 3-7. Ma Long's making his way back. Now, in case you're curious, we talked about Fang Zhendong, Xu Xin, but the rest of the bench, Lin Gaoyuan and Wang Chuqin. Quite promising young players. Lin Gaoyuan, you've probably seen on the world tours. He's been given a peek of the real world, the international stage. Several tests, actually. Some of the toughest losses we've seen in the last few years, Will.
Yeah, I remember one that sticks in my mind to Timo Boll, wasn't it?
Yep, 4-10. Yeah. Look at this hooking shot from Ma Long. He's Cho Wang. That means he's really fighting here. It starts, you know it's starting to matter. You can't be down 0-1 and play tentatively. He needs to take the first. And a brushing backhand with the same side spin as that last loop. Or at least the same direction of side spin anyway. Ma Long regarded as the most complete player in the game, which is quite a compliment. He's the multivitamin of men's table tennis. That's a perfect setup here. Fast down the line to the forehand. Second time we've seen it in the exact opposite corner to follow. At the exchange rate since 3-7, Ma Long won't let Gardoche get to 11 before him. Won't let him get to 10 before him. But let's see. On 1 foot, saves it from the middle. What an acrobatic save. I can't believe it didn't hit his shirt. Right. Really a chance here. This one was so surprising. Ma Long didn't seem fazed at all, though. Held his ground, still in position. Gardoche had the opening. That was that look. He knows. We saw it last night in the fifth match. 1 point between them. A very difficult serve to receive. Gardoche has been solid so far.
Getting opportunities in the rally, though, isn't he? And that's great. You take confidence from that.
And it's funny, against Ma Long, you don't get opportunities, you earn them. And Robert Gardoche is working so hard to stay in these points. That's 2 points in a row that I think he realized could have gone either way. Not should have, but definitely could have. Tied back up. Look, the combination's so unpredictable. You know, Jill and I have talked about this a lot, but it's so important to constantly have the opponent chasing your patterns. If they can't guess where you're going to go next, it makes it really tough for them to set up. And especially with Gardoche's style of play, aggressive on the back of the table. Oh, just misses it one more time. You know, it's still the right tactic to play aggressive the way he is. I think Gardoche is playing very smart table tennis. To be 9-9 with Ma Long in a best of five here in the first game, the most important one, other than the last, of course, says a lot for a 39-year-old world-ranked number 55 from a country that's quite small and a very strong team, but still, you've got stronger in Europe. The top seeds, after all. China, the number two seeds in this tournament, to Germany by world ranking and team ranking right now. Solid receive. He did the side swipe deep to the backhand, but the follow-up shot, a little trouble. Now game point for Ma Long. Will, what are you thinking?
You did call this, Adam, didn't you? He said
he's going to get to 10. Yeah. That's right. Ma Long will not allow. Captain Long, is it a no? Would you mind if yes? Do you think you could give me no? Game point. Ooh! So game point saved, still a chance. Yeah, for me, game one is so crucial. If Ma Long gets a little bit in cruise control mode and he's loose, it's just so tough to come back.
Have you ever witnessed him get nervous and play a little bit inhibited?
Yeah, many times. Many times. Sure. That's almost the only time I've seen a competitive match against him. Many times. I just feel like since 2015, he's found a confidence and he's able to zone in, just drop into that sort of sunken place and dominate the opponent. I guess he'd be dropping his opponent into the sunken place in terms of get out references or scores anyway, but back in control with game point. Gonna do? What's the receiver, Robbie Gardoche, gonna do? Oh, gets away with it. When Ma Long pulls back like that and turns the corner, you're already packing your bags and getting ready for game two. And the tongue out here, Ma Long doesn't miss many shots like this. Sits up too. I think the fact that Gardosh is waiting there for that flat hit cross court adds a little bit of pressure. Maybe just the tension, because Ma Long has to realize how important game one is, even with the lineup waiting behind him. There's a lot of pressure on him to take this. Ooh! So game point to Gardosh. Remember, he had match point against Zhang Jike in 2014, but in the end, Zhang Jike took it. Good serve in near the body, the solid backhand waiting. It's not the serve itself, it's the third ball that's waiting that forces Ma Long to make a quality receive. So game point to Gardosh. Oh, the flip does it! The flip! Robbie Gardosh on fire! I mean, we've got a dragon on the other side. Ma Long in a best of 1 point, they're almost infinitely better than in a best of seven match. Luck plays a bigger role. Momentum, I mean, there's just less time for someone to settle in. The importance of that first game. Ma Long here right down the middle. Tough to get a racket in front and on top of that. Not a bad receive at all. It's just Ma Long read where it was going and was right there waiting. I could be wrong, but that might be the first game that Ma Long has lost in a World Team Championships since before 2012.
Wow.
I think he was 21. Yeah, 21 and 0 in matches without dropping a game since 2012. I'll check in with the Ma Long fan club for details. Did I show you my Ma Long passport?
I love that.
Thanks. Check out the inside. It's pretty amazing.
Yeah, that is cool.
Wow. Little break here off the top edge of the racket. Will's impressed with my Ma Long passport.
I love this Ma Long passport. I wish you could see it, guys.
I wanted to show it at the airport, but I thought if they're not table tennis guys, they might not appreciate it as much as you and I do.
It's brilliant.
What if they love accidentally that. Stamped it? I don't think that would happen. I stay in Sweden for the rest of my life?
Yeah, pretty much. Oh, good serve.
So first towel break of the game. The dictator with a score that's a little bit more like what table tennis fans would have predicted in the first, second, and third games of this. But the only way this will only be three games now is if Gardosh takes the second and third, which would be, again, the second biggest news of this tournament.
This is a backlash, is it? The Ma Long backlash. I'm losing the first game now.
Oh, right, right.
Yeah.
Yeah, you don't want to see him when he's angry.
Yeah.
Six, two.
Second point for Gardosh. You know, I was looking at it in terms of Ma Long being the dragon. If Gardosh had an N in it instead of an S, it'd be an anagram for dragon. It's got all the letters except that N, and bet you didn't think of that.
I didn't.
Oh, a backhand counter exchange. Looked like an apology there at the end. Not sure if it caught an edge of a racket or whatnot, but placement very wise here. We see this a lot with the cross-court touch shots. That little bit of side spin early on. Yeah, can see the apology there from Robbie. I mean, 3 points, you know, another thing, not only a best of five, but we're only playing 11 points as it has been since, what, 2001. So games can turn quicker. Comebacks get recovered quite quickly. It's funny, Will, someone could be playing my favorite player and still upsets are so exciting to witness. It's just always exciting. It shakes things up. It makes you believe that there's anything is possible, right?
Yeah, and that's why we love sport, the unpredictability. And Gardosh would be so happy taking that first game. I think it was a game that, you know, when you're playing a player that's so, you know, such a legendary player like Ma Long, to take that first game is what you need. You need, otherwise they can just run away from you, can't they?
Yeah, and I think it's a very fine balance. I think he was thrilled to get game one, but toned it right back into focus. It's like, yes, I took the first step, but the job is far from done. And losing 3-2, 17-15 would be an exciting, fun stat. But if you don't beat Ma Long, people don't remember it for very long.
9-4.
We can count the non-Chinese players in the last handful of years that have beaten Ma Long. I think two. Wow. Timo Boll and Jung Song-un. I mean, these are... Jung Song-un was essentially a no-name internationally, but that credit, it's like having a hit single.
Yeah.
Behind the table, the odds go way down. Gardoche tried to stay in the point, but tried to get aggressive even from behind the table. Perfect placement, Ma Long just bullying him off the table into the middle. One game point saved, five to go for Ma Long. Flip goes out 11-5. Quite a different score than in game one, where it was 13-11. Ma Long dominates, and we'll be back for game number three to see who takes the lead right after this. We played quite well throughout. We're back for game number three. This is the side of the table that nobody has lost on, the side that Gardoche is now serving on. I'm not especially superstitious, but there are practical reasons why this could be a factor. Good spinny shot, followed up with a change of pace, a flatter bullet. You're not going to see two shots the same unless they're bullets to good placements. I mean, Gardoche is really mixing it up and sort of has to do that to break the rhythm of Ma Long, which isn't easy to do.
Gardoche has got quite a good history against Chinese opposition. Why do you think that is? I'm getting some results through that he's had in the past. Twice he's lost close to Zhang Jike. Why do you think that is?
A handful of things. One is timing. He's close to the table. Two, he's unafraid. He plays bold, and I think he has a really good concept of how to play under pressure, high-risk play. I mean, after all, he's 39 years old, and he's playing super aggressive on top of the table. This is pretty unusual.
One, two.
Nice turn of the corner here, loaded with spin first. You know, in terms of practice partners, the best practice team, the best everything team, no question, China. But in terms of practice, they don't have people playing European strokes so much in the Chinese national team. I actually say that not knowing for sure. I would just imagine it's a little bit tougher to raise somebody to that level and be like, hey, all the good habits you learned that make you dominant, we're going to ask you to take a back seat and pull that elbow in a little bit and change your rubber.
I remember having this conversation with my friend Dan, actually.
Dan Ives?
Yeah, Dan Ives. And he said that he believes in the national center, training centers in China, they have got European-style players, like Timo Boll, like these guys, and they, to get the variation.
I wouldn't be surprised. I mean, that's why I sort of qualified my statement, because I realized they're just so well prepared. Yeah. Now, acknowledging this serve here, that deserves some acknowledgement. Yeah. That was the perfect length. When do you see Ma Long hesitating like that at the back edge of the table? Look at the scoreboard. 5-1 at the towel break. This is complete role reversal. I mean, 2-1. This is when your opponent is one game away and they've already beaten you twice. In terms of pressure, Ma Long will be tentative, he will be tense, and he will be fired up. He can't be calm and cool down 1-2 in a best of five. The quiet, quiet Ma Long fan club. Hashtag go exclamation point Ma Long. Watching nervously. You know, it's funny, I learned that in fan culture, there are different fan clubs for different players that have different rules about how you cheer and when you cheer. If Ma Long loses 3 points in a row, you will hear, Jiao, Ma Long, Jiao, but not every point.
Wow, that's it. That's really interesting to hear.
Yeah. If they feel that he needs it, otherwise they let him do his thing. It's a very respectful fan club. And other fan clubs, sometimes Ding Ning's fan clubs, Zhang Jiko's fan clubs, they just feel like, you know what, be there every point and make it, be vocal about it, and different cultures for different fan clubs.
With regards to Zhang Jike, is he coming, can he come back, or is there any way back? Do you know anything about that, Adam?
6-3.
Well, I've heard a rumor that he is coming back, but I'm skeptical to see that he'll ever be in the form that we remember him in from, you know, 2011 through 2014. He had some amazing years. And in training, he looks amazing every time there's a comeback video. But in the tournaments, I just haven't seen him come back to that level. Wow, that last one. I think Gardoche was saying a little bit more on the elbow here. The idea was right, but the execution was just a little bit too clear a forehand for Ma Long. Ma Long is like a tripod that you just, he's so stable, he's set up to not fall. He's always on balance, and even when he's not, he recovers so quickly. Agile, fast, even creative. I know he doesn't get credit for that. Some people say machine because he plays the smart game and doesn't miss, but he really has some of the most spectacular shots we've seen. Playing every wrist. He got the break. He got a net, which was crucial in here. A little bit of luck and the tongue out again. And when Ma Long goes to the backhand serve, I mean, this is a sign of trouble. Like Timo when he was playing Dima, and he's like, the serves haven't been working, and he just went to these nothing backhand serves and won the game. I mean, that was one of the most fascinating indicators of a mature, flexible player. Look at this once again. 8-4. From 5-1 to 6-4, Ma Long started creeping right back in. Second towel break of the game. Alexander Chen there on the bench supporting heavily, part of the team. Gardoche really, it's every shot is like, I have to take a risk. If I play anything safe, I'm done.
You don't see these backhand serves much from Ma Long, do you? I haven't seen them at all for a while.
Under trouble, yeah. I mean, on the world tour since... I don't know. I've seen him play a handful of times. I've seen him go to it, but only when he's in trouble. Wow! Every shot, the serve is risky, fast and long to the backhand. Ma Long rips it, and who's there waiting for not a block, but a counter? Gardoche right now is on volume 11 for every shot. Wow, the serve, this is how Ma Long used to serve. I don't see him try these aces. Gardoche has tried it probably about 5 times so far in this match. Maybe 4, I don't know, but with more frequency, with greater frequency than anyone I've seen in the Champions Division this tournament, and now 6 game points.
Ooh. It's the unpredictability, isn't it, of the serve and the way he's playing. It's so unpredictable.
It has to be. If Ma Long has any sign of what's to come, he'll be there waiting and it'll just be devastating. We've seen greater comebacks. Ma Long against Timo, similar score. Ooh.
Six.
But he took the chance. He turned the corner. If Ma Long doesn't play it the other way, I think Gardoche has a decent shot at winning this point the way he's been playing. And it does add a bit of pressure. Ma Long right there just looks like a drill. Calm and cool, sees the opening. 4 game points left for a 2-1 lead for the unthinkable.
Seven.
When you have that 1 point, it's like I said, obviously Gardoche and myself are quite different in skill level, but he's had nets, he's had a little bit of luck when he needs it. And a big timeout here. I think this is the perfect time for a timeout. You've still got 3. And against Ma Long, in some senses, it might actually be a little bit late. Mm-hmm. In terms of cushion, 3 points against Ma Long is like a half a point against other people. For a reason, for many. Oh, he got the net. He went safe with the serve. Like I considered maybe after a little discussion, Ma Long saves the net, stays in the point. Now this is tough. The parachute has been pulled. The lifeline has been called. Gardoche looking for that crossover point. Ma Long is so tough. When you think about areas where he might be uncomfortable in the backhand, you're looking for that elbow. The wide backhand doesn't seem to be a problem. Still 2 game points left. 4 in a row for Ma Long. First shot is in. I'm really wondering, you know, Gardoche plays it fast, aggressive. It's worked out quite well for him, but it's been trouble in terms of changing patterns. So that one's a bit spinnier. I mean, that's what I was thinking. If we see a really loaded spin shot that's a little low, maybe even shallow on the table, it could be tough for the timing of Ma Long to counter. He's been at the back edge of the table.
He went for the forehand flick last time, I think, in the last game. A big forehand flick to win the game. This is another big point here.
No, oh, he does it! Robert Gardoche! I can't believe it after all that. 10-4, five in a row for Ma Long. Was it a long push? I don't know, but the counter cross court has Ma Long shaking his head. Snap shotgun reaction. How can you be on the seat at all on the bench for Austria? I mean, your chair's got to be on fire in moments like this. In Moscow to Timo Boll, and it was 3-1. Gardoche does not want to go to a fifth. Now, Ma Long is on the side of the table that hasn't lost yet, Will.
If you're a betting man, Adam, I know you're not, but if you were, what would you say the odds were here for Gardoche?
Well, 1-4?
Really? You still think it's, yeah.
Well, it's Ma Long.
Yeah.
I mean, that sounds grim, and it's not my job to believe.
Yeah, yeah.
It's Ma Long's job to believe in himself. It's Robert Gardoche's job to believe in himself. I'm just trying to keep it real from a statistical standpoint. I mean, we're looking at a player who's only lost once in a World Team Championships and played 21-0 since 2012 without dropping a game.
But that's remarkable.
It really is. Yeah. And that's also more reason that he would feel the pressure, because being in a situation like this is as foreign to Ma Long as Gardoche is to China.
Yeah.
I mean, this hasn't happened to him since 2010. He probably can't even remember. Well, I'm sure he remembers what it feels like, but it's got to be strange. And don't get me wrong. You know I'm a fan of upsets, regardless of who's playing.
Yeah.
It's just so exciting. So, yeah, I hate to put a number on it just because can't predict the future.
Yeah.
That's the best way to look foolish.
Yeah.
But still, I think pretty, I don't know, educated guess.
Yeah.
My best reasonable claim, hopefully.
Lap 2 all.
Off the top of the net, but a beautiful counter, and even the cover, the receive of serve here from Gardoche. Watch how baseline the second bounce is. There's that spinny one. Ma Long a bit flatter on the drive, and then the counter.
It's going to be interesting to see how Ma Long, you know, can pull this back together. You know, he's a legend. He's one of the best of all time, but can he handle this type of pressure? I think we know he can, but
will he, right?
Yeah.
Oh, it looked like it sat up. You know what? Gardoche has missed two shots that were big shots in game number one.
Yeah.
And he came back to win the game. We saw it last night against Portugal. He had his head back in the air saying, why on earth? How could you miss this? That pose right there, but he's regrouped, he's regathered, and he's come back to win not only the games against Ma Long, but his match last night. You know, I thought Austria versus India could have been trouble, and look at them here.
Yeah.
India, again, with six men in the world top 100, just took the Commonwealth gold medal.
Oh.
Beautiful backhand punch. Gardoche ahead. It's funny, as commentators, we've been thanking China for the longest time for giving us meal breaks and rests with all their 3-0 victories, but if this one went to the fifth and deciding match, I mean...
Wow, that would be amazing.
I love moments in history and being here for them, and as much as I love the Chinese national team, seeing a bit more of an even battle just would inspire. Good touch, good placement from Ma Long. I think Gardoche says, why not flick? Why not go for the shorter stroke aggressively? But that's just the perfect placement of Ma Long. Watch this ball. Is it going to come off? Is it going to come off?
Ooh,
barely. Jeez.
Let 4-0.
I think that gave Ma Long a little bit of confidence that down into the table, let mid-service, or mid-point service. It's funny, these little things, you know, sometimes a player will do that. Both Ma Long and Fang Zhendong like to do that. I see a lot of players actually hitting it back down into the table after a let is called. And there's just sort of like a swag about it, a way of saying like, I'm sure that the point is over, but I'm still giving you back the ball.
Yeah.
These are the points. Cardoso was up 4-3, yeah?
Yeah.
Now three in a row for Ma Long. In terms of what makes the greatest and what makes a champion, I think how you play under pressure, how you play when you're down, it's easy to win gracefully, it's easy to stay on top. Actually, take that back. It's not always easy to stay on top, but easier in many senses in terms of grit, perseverance.
Sometimes to win when you're not playing your best is what makes, the real champions.
When you have to grind out matches like this, you know.
That bending backhand, there's a bit of side spin on it as well that makes it more awkward. And again, with tension, under pressure.
Mistiming it.
Right. You tighten up a little bit. This is why being calm is so important. It's a fine balance. But that hesitation, here's the spin shot. There's the bend. But a tight Ma Long, it's just not the same, right?
Yeah.
You can't adjust as quickly. You're a little bit slower. It's like, think about on a day when you lift weights and then within the next 2 days you play table tennis and you're missing all these shots. Yeah. That's what it's like being nervous on a smaller scale, but the same effect. When you said not playing his best, I think that's, of course, true because we've seen him play his best, but I don't think he's playing poorly. No. I think Gardoche is playing almost perfectly. Yeah. Like just doing everything he can to make it challenging, to make it unusual and uncomfortable for a player who's so comfortable with almost everything. We are getting close here. We're getting into the business end of the game, as Don Parker always said. And I learned that he believes somebody probably said before him that he probably heard somewhere. So now I don't feel so bad. Don't feel like I have to copyright him every time. But I did anyway.
The legend that is Don Parker.
That's right. So Gardoche with serves here. Two big serves. Ma Long is quite fired up right now. You can hear it. I mean, every point, especially against serve. That is not an easy ball. Ma Long takes it from below the net and counters it down the middle of the table with pace, too. It's the right idea for Gardoche. He's trying to get in. It's tough to be much closer to the table than that, although it did feel like he was just a step behind as he was trying to lean forward and just add some pace to that ball. Where's that bending backhand? Inside out forehand. Where's the down the line forehand when he turns the corner?
He needs something very special now.
It sounds so dangerous to turn the corner here.
Yeah.
You don't want to leave anything unlocked with Ma Long in the neighborhood.
Yeah.
And the flick goes out. Ma Long up 10-7 here in game number 4. 3 game points to send us to a deciding 5th. You know, credit to Gardoche. He looks a little bit down, but he looks like he's clearly focused and knows how important it is to play every point as if it's 0-0. Mm-hmm. Back to the game plan on the receive. 3 game points for the Dragon.
10-7.
Thank you. with that receive. Solid serve from Ma Long to earn the popped up third ball. And even the bench is watching nervously. The face of Fang Zhendong here, scratching the head, just very guarded optimism, if that, from the players. But we will see the decider, Robbie Gardoche versus Ma Long, 34 months at world number one and still arguably at the top of his game. Stay right here to see what happens. Just enough to make sure he plays his game and stays loose. Wins the last game 11-7. Outstanding, the backhand. Only a few players on earth can consistently play this shot with confidence from behind the table and finish a point.
Chinese bench really animated here after this point.
Okay. You mentioned Robert Gardoche has to start strong, and I think the point was very well played, but score-wise, it's like losing close versus winning. They're just night and day different. So if you don't get the point here, in terms of confidence, it's tough to gain confidence playing well and losing every point.
And it's distressing as well for Gardoche, because he's played, he's played two good points at the start of this last game, hasn't he? He hasn't done a lot wrong.
Yeah, that's true. That was the sorry, but also the
Sorry.
And that's just how important it is. Ma Long, again, as fair as they come.
Yeah.
He gets the apology in first, but can't repress the excitement.
Yeah.
And just has to pump himself up, really. I mean, he's doing everything he can to bring out the best player, because that's what he needs right now. No timeouts left for Gardoche.
Huge respect for Ma Long here in this match, because I remember him playing a counter topspin, a really hard counter topspin in the last game, which, you know, it takes courage, you know. And he's come back from that, and he's won, you know, he's come from behind, and now he's dominating this last game. You've got to give a lot of respect for Ma Long for coming back.
Gardoche has worked so hard to earn good opportunities. Same in game one. But Ma Long has just turned it up a notch in terms of his consistency and pressure. I think it's interesting to see. I've noticed with a lot of the pros, the change of grip on service is common, but to see two fingers under the backhand side of the racket, something I've noticed a bit more. Truls Mortegard is one of the few who uses that sort of mid-play, just sort of his constant grip.
Yeah.
Schlager serve. It's funny, in terms of guessing odds and whatnot, I'm thinking back, and it would have been very bold down 1-2 when you asked me to say 1 out of 10, and it might have sounded crazy, but I think many would have said that. That being said, Gardoche had 7-7 and had serves in game number 4. That was, for me, a really big pivot point that late in the match. 6-0. The other way around, if it were 6-0 and you asked me, I might say 50-50.
And now Ma Long's really starting to relax, isn't he? You know, you can see the difference in his performance in this last. It's like he's, you know, become himself after that fourth. Now he can really flow.
Yeah, I think he's found that healthy balance between pumped up and just zen mode. Ma Long has embodied the dragon. So not a point yet in the decider for Robert Gardoche. He will fight till the very end of this.
Oh, it's a shame. It's a shame to see it, though, for Robert Gardoche, isn't it? Because he's put in such a good effort, and to go down like this isn't fair, really.
To liken this to someone who's, I don't know, to help compare this to something for non-table tennis people.
Nice. What can you do?
It's like having the biggest break of your life right in front of you. Like having everything you've ever wanted on a plate in front of you and not being able to eat it.
10-1.
And a mercy point happened before we came back. Ma Long gave the mercy point. Gardosh is going to play it out. I mean, it's funny. I've seen mercy points given right back, but in this tournament, you have to give everything because you've got the whole team watching and you've got a long fight ahead. In theory, if there's an upset against the Chinese team, Robert Gardosh could be playing another match. Yeah. I need to look at the lineup again. 8 match points for Ma Long.
3.
Good attempt there. 360 for Ma Long. It still seems unthinkable. But so did it from the start that he'd even get one game, let alone two. That Ma Long, that point continued a lot longer than I thought it would, and the fans have a lot to celebrate right now.